On Friday night, Shark Fight 17 emanated from the Dr. Pepper Arena in Frisco, Texas. In the evening's main event, former three-time NCAA Division I wrestling champion Jake Roschalt hoped for redemption when he was paired with Eddie Bravo-schooled Matt Horwich in a rematch from their 2010 encounter. From the onset, the Cobra Kai representative utilized his striking to score when the fight was upright, attacking with straight punches to the body in hopes of wearing down the eccentric former IFL middleweight champion. The 32-year-old Horwich was not afraid to engage and landed flurries of punches throughout the contest. As soon as Roschalt saw an opening, he used his grappling background to force this fight to the canvas, but Horwich had no answer fighting from his back. Throughout the three rounds, Roschalt controlled the action, but it was his submission defense, durable chin, and improved striking that seemed to be the difference, as the judges awarded the unanimous decision to Roschalt, who improves to 12-3. In the night's co-feature, former UFC heavyweight champion Rico Rodriguez was matched with last-minute replacement Doug Williams, as original opponent Carl Canothe was pulled from the card because of a weight disparity. The BJJ black belt Rodriguez looked a little sluggish, but managed to get this fight to the ground where he controlled from the top before sinking in a fight-ending rear naked choke at the 216 mark of the opening frame. Rodriguez gets the victory of the overmatched Williams and extends his winning streak to 12 and is now set to battle Kimbo killer Seth Petruzzelli at Bellator 48 in August. In a light heavyweight tilt, former MFC 205-pound champion Emmanuel Newton challenged Greco-Roman wrestling standout Irir Latifi. Over the course of three rounds, the American dominated the action, setting the pace with his stand-up abilities, while Latifi tried his best to defend. The sledgehammer had no answer for the King's MMA student, proved to the audience that he could take the best from the more experience Newton had to offer. In the end, after some initial confusion, the hardcore kid was given the unanimous decision with a win over the tough Latifi. Eric Perez battled Douglas Frey for three rounds and his persistence paid off as the Jackson submission fighter was awarded the hard-fought unanimous decision win. Perez improves to 8-5 as he earns his third straight victory.